In this lesson, we will learn how to use some auxiliary tools that help us control the precision of our drawings. Those tools can be found in the status bar, and though we have already used some of them in the previous lessons, in this lesson we are going to elaborate on them. Let's begin with the first tool, which is the 2D object snaps. With this particular tool active, the cursor is being pulled to certain points of the drawing. Firstly, to make this tool appear in the status bar, I will click on the customization icon in the lower right corner and check the 2D object snaps option. When the icon appears, I can click on it to activate it. Once it is active, it becomes a lighter shade of blue. Next to the icon, there is an arrow. I will click on the arrow to expand the list with the available snaps, and I'm going to activate the endpoint and the midpoint. The endpoint snaps the cursor to the start or the end of the line, a curve or an arc. On the other hand, midpoint snaps the cursor to the middle of a line. With these two active, I will select the line tool and I will move the cursor to the end of the line that you see in the first example. I will click on the left end point of the line and then on the left end point of the curve to create a line that connects those two endpoints. Next, I'm going to draw a random circle centered at the right end point of the line. Finally, I'm going to connect the middle of the line with the other end of the curve. At this point, I'm going to move on to the next example, so I'm going to reopen the snaps list and deactivate both the endpoint and the midpoint snaps. I will activate the center and the quadrant snaps instead. The center snap snaps the cursor to the center of circles, ellipses, and arcs. The quadrant snap snaps the cursor to a quadrant point of an arc, circle, or ellipse. In this example, a circle has already been created and I'm going to create a concentric ellipse. So I will activate the ellipse tool and move the cursor to the circle. Once the center snap appears, I will click on it to specify the center of the ellipse. Then, I will specify the dimensions of the ellipse without typing the exact numbers. Lastly, I will connect the circle's quadrant points with the polyline tool. So I will activate the tool, and once the symbol of the north quadrant appears, I will click on it. Then, I will click on the west quadrant, then on the south, then on the east, and lastly on the north quadrant again to close the polyline. When the polyline is finished, I will exit the command to continue with the next example. Similar to the center snap is the geometric center, which snaps the cursor to the centroid of closed profiles, such as rectangles, polygons, and so on. I will activate the snap and deactivate all the rest. Then, I will select the multiple points tool to place a point in the centroid of its shape. Notice that when the cursor moves onto a closed polyline, a symbol appears in its centroid. I will click to place a point in the geometric center of its shape and exit the command. For the next example, I need only the node and perpendicular snaps active. The node snap snaps the cursor to points, while the perpendicular snap snaps the cursor to a point perpendicular to the selected geometric object. So with those snaps active, I'm going to select the line tool and specify the start of the line at the point. As for the next point of the line, I will move the cursor to the existing line, and when the perpendicular symbol appears, I will click to specify it. In this way, the two lines are perpendicular to each other. The next snap we are going to learn is the intersection snap, which snaps the cursor to the point where two lines or curves cross. As you can see, there are already two lines that intersect, and I will use their intersection point as the center of the circle I am going to create. So without further ado, I will activate the circle tool and move the cursor close to the intersection of the lines. Once the symbol appears, I will click to specify the circle center and click once more to create the circle with a random radius. At this point, I should mention that the apparent intersection, which is a little lower in the list, snaps the cursor to the visual intersection of two objects that do not intersect in 3D space, but may appear to intersect in the current view. The next example is about the extension snap. I will activate the extension snap and deactivate the others like I did in the previous examples. The extension snap causes a temporary extension line or arc to be displayed when the cursor passes over the endpoint of objects. In this way, we can specify points on their extension. So, let's say that I want to place a point at the intersection of these two lines. However, they will not intersect unless they are extended. Instead of changing the line's length, I can make use of this snap. So I will activate the Multiple Points tool, move the cursor on the endpoint of the first line, and as you can see, when I move the cursor, a reference line which indicates its extension appears. Without clicking, I will move the cursor to the endpoint of the other line and move upwards. Same as previously, a reference line appears. I will move upwards and notice that the point where the two extension lines intersect appears with an X. I will click on it to place a point there. Then I will press Escape to deactivate the tool. Now that we have learned the extension snap, we will see how we can create parallel lines using the 2D object snaps. So I will activate the parallel snap and deactivate the extension snap. Next, I will activate the Line tool and click somewhere near the first line to specify the first point of the line. Before I continue, I need to identify the line that the new line which I am creating will be parallel to. To do that, all I have to do is hover my cursor on this line and when the parallel symbol appears, to move the cursor back toward the line that I'm creating. When the path of the line is parallel to the existing line, an alignment path is displayed. I am going to use this path to create a parallel line. Once I'm done, I will deactivate the Line tool to move to the next example. When we want to create lines tangent to an arc, circle, or an ellipse, we need to activate the tangent snap. If, for example, I wish to create a line tangent to both circles, I will select the Line tool, and with the tangent snap active, I will move the cursor on the first circle. The symbol of tangency appears immediately, and I will click on the side which I wish the line to start. To specify the next point of the line, I will hover the cursor on the second circle and click on it once the tangency symbol appears again. As you can see, a line tangent to both circles has been created. The next snap I'm going to activate and show you how it is used is the nearest snap. Nearest snaps the cursor to the nearest point on an object, such as an arc, circle, ellipse, line, point, polyline, or spline. To give you a clearer idea of what this snap is for, I will place a point on the line. In case I don't care for the exact position of the point and the only thing I want to make sure of is that the point will be placed on the line, this snap is what I'm looking for. So I will activate the Multiple Points tool and notice that once the cursor goes near the line, the nearest symbol appears. I will click on a random point on the line to place a point. Then, I will click again to place another one, and finally deactivate the tool. As you can see, both points are placed on the line. Last but not least is the insertion snap. Insertion snaps to the insertion point of objects such as blocks and texts, and we will elaborate on this snap in the relevant lesson. Before we finish this lesson, I should mention that even though snaps can be very helpful when they are used right, they can be extremely confusing when they are all active in a large project.